These are two areas which I'm going to call A-tech. So I form a majority of the group here. I'm an engineer of education. I've done my electronics and communication engineering from Chennai. And I worked after that for 2 years in an IT company, Satyam Computers, which is now Mahindra Satyam. And I worked in pre-sales and development sector. Nothing was to boast about that, so I'll move to the next phase. I was interested in marketing and then I eventually joined CodeBridge in capacity of sales, business development manager. I joined Hyderabad and I was in a division which was taking care of security systems, which is primarily your CCTV, fire alarm systems, gates, under vehicle scanners, and so on. 6 months after spending in Hyderabad, I was asked to move to Chennai along with my colleague, and we were given a task to revamp the entire branch. Chennai branch wasn't rent for the last 5 years. It was not doing its targets, and we were asked to generate revenues. So we had just one key account in Chennai. Key account is account which generates repeat business to work. We had just one key account. So we had to really, the task was cut out. We had to really work hard in delivering what was required by us. And in 2.5 years, we were able to have key accounts like NPCIL, nuclear power plant, IGCAR, which is Indira Gandhi Atomic Center of Research, and private companies like IDC, Marriott, Asanda's IT Park, and so forth. And now, I'm going to come to the point where how the sales cycle in a B2B business works. Usually, as a sales guy, you get a lead from your HO, from your head office. This is a particular customer who might have a need for a security product. Or you go into the market by yourself and have a cold call, which is you just knock at the door of the customer and ask whether there is a requirement for it. Then you usually discuss with the end user of the customer, say in my case, a security manager, who will handle this product. And then you talk to him, understand his requirements, and then see the feasibility of the security products, and also a sort of a report of how a security system will help the security to make the premises more secure. Then the file actually goes to the influencer or the buyer. Influencer, the buyer could be the same person, or influencer and buyer could be separate people. So the mapping of the accounts goes in this cycle where you map the end customer who says that he would like to go first for the product and say with this technology. And then you convince the influencer or the buyer in saying okay for the product. And then finally, you also map the purchase officer to get your negotiations through and helping you to collect the money, the outstanding of the project. So this is how the cycle goes. And once the order was done, I was also involved in execution of the projects. I was managing my service team to execute the project in a timely manner, which also obviously affects my account receivables outstanding. So because account receivable outstanding is extremely important, because let me tell you, we had a case today in FADM where it was said that the marketing guy will be given a compensation or given an incentive because he had an incentive of getting marketing. But in my company, we were not only evaluated on sales, we were evaluated on our working capital requirement, of how fast the money is being recovered from the customer, and also how good is the management of stocks in the warehouse, the inventories. So the incentives to sales, say only 50-60% of the 40% of the incentives also reflect these options. And so 2.5 years down the line, Chennai branch is doing extremely well. For the last 2 years consecutively, we have got what is the best branch performing in terms of sales. And another metric which usually in companies where we measure the performance of a particular branch is how much the target it's asked to achieve. And Chennai has the highest target as Bombay and Delhi. So So we have reached a stage, branches reached a stage from nowhere to be one of the leading branches in Godrej. The key skill sets, which I would say, which is very critical in delivering what is required, is people skills and perseverance. I think in B2B especially, especially in technical selling, the gestation period is very high. Because you need to work, say, at least 10 months from the inception of a project to the completion of the project. So it takes 10 months and you need to have a lot of patience. And I mean, traveling is something which comes as a part of the sales. So I used to travel entire breadth and width of Tamil Nadu, right from Chennai to places like Kanyakumari, Ramanathapuram, places where you don't have anything to properly eat and you need to walk for 5-10 kilometers and take site measurements of 20-25 kilometers. So there's a lot of hard work in that sense. So these are key factors which I think would help you to contribute to the revenues for the company. That's it.
What were the major issues you were facing and how did it came out of that?
Major issues is the product itself, because security product as a such is not a very need-based product. You need to create a need in terms of in the head of a customer. You know, certain places, yeah, for example, say a Navy base, which was one of the key accounts, and in a nuclear power plant, yeah, you have a requirement of security because you have a set of, you know, extremist threat. But say in a place like Ascender's ID bar, you don't require a security system, but it's advisable to have. So it's very, very important to create a need in the minds of customers. So the initial ice-breaking session is very, very, very important. And that you actually get it by your technical expertise and also how this product is going to help the user in his endeavor. So that is very, very important. See, down south, in some terms of say very rural areas, were primarily government companies, government sectors, or PSU, say a Navy base or a nuclear power plant, where the requirement is already there. You have a requirement of security systems for sure, with the threats what India has. So, but private sectors are always primarily from Chennai. So there also, in terms of say, I was lucky in the sense that hotel industry had a mandate from the tourism ministry that you need to have security systems to get a 5-star rating. That obviously becomes the choice of the customer and makes my job a little bit easy. Yeah.
You must have encountered several problems and you must have dealt with it. After doing this course here, what is that you could have said one problem you could have done differently after gaining knowledge from here? What we study now?
I think operational efficiency, especially what we are doing for the last 2 weeks, very important. And also one more thing is a supply chain point. I mean, the both are actually linked with it. And that's why I always say marketing and supply chain are like husband and wife. And what they need to do is business, because it's very important that because if supply chain guy is not delivering the product to a marketer or sales guy, the customer is going to pick the sales guy the first, and the whole ecosystem gets up.
Targets, is it set by management or is it set by you?
It's set by management. Whatever you do, if you do X, X plus
3%. You know, I'm intrigued to know that how do you differentiate your product in B2B that to in a product like security system? I mean, since you go out in the market, so how you are different from say Zycon? I don't know, you are
offering. Yeah, I know.
How do you differentiate? What do you say to a client and why I'm better?
End game is relationship. But how do you reach a relationship is through your technical expertise. My major competitors were Honeywell and Siemens. So technical expertise is something which customer is looking for somebody to do his job. He is supposed to procure a certain security product, say a CCTV, to monitor his building. Now, as a supplier, if you can do the job on behalf of him, if you can provide an analysis of the industry, give the breakup, what all people do, and then you can push your case, it becomes the job easier. So the technical expertise actually leads to a relationship where customer has confidence in you.
So products are differentiated on the basis
of technical expertise.
On the basis of technology.
And of course, then the things like after sales service, brand image of Godrej, the dealer network, all this stuff. But basically, it's primarily the ice breakage is always is technical expertise, which leads to respect and relationship.